Hello, hi, assalamualaikum everyone. So this is Miss Nasiha. Okay, we are going to do chapter number 3, freehold and leasehold valuation. But this time, we are going to only focus on what happens if there is a multi-terms and reversion. So without further ado, let's begin our class for today with Ummu Kitab Al-Fatiha. Okay, today we are going to learn on multi-terms and reversion valuation. So, what is multi-term? So, multi-term basically means multiple, multi, more than one. So, in this case, it would be sometimes two terms involved and then reversion. Reversion, yeah, not revision. Reversion basically means the period where the property will be revert back to the owner. Okay, so let's look at the example. Okay, a freeholder let out his property. Okay, so he said that he's going to let out his property for 10 years. The rental would be 50,000 net per annum. Then another 15 years, that would be the different rate, the different rental. The rental will become 55,000 net per annum. So remember, the rental must be in the form of net rent and also must make sure that it is in the form of per annum. If the rent is in the form of monthly basis, then don't forget you must multiply it with 12. If the net, the rent is not in the net form, let's say for example the landlord are responsible to pay the outgoings, then don't forget you must minus the outgoings. Okay, you can assume that would be 20% of the rent. Okay, so you must make sure that the rent is net and also per annum. So as you can see from the question, there would be two periods, two terms. The first term is 10 years, whereby the rental is 50,000, and the second term, the second period, is 15 years, where the rental has slightly increased and it become 55,000 per annum. However, this tenant is still paying lower than the market rental value. Okay, so the rental value, other people, the rental basically means similar property. So the other people is paying higher. That would be 60,000 ringgit net per annum. Okay, and then it is given in the question also that the yield of comparable. So the yield of comparable basically means DARY, all risk yield. So the all risk yield is 7% per annum. If it is not given in the question, then you have to calculate the all risk yield. Remember the formula? The formula of all risk yield is rental value divided by capital value of similar properties times by 100. Okay, so now that have a look at the diagram. Okay, so that the diagram would be looking like this. Okay, so first term would be 10 years. Okay, the second term, that will be plus another 15 years. So that will be 25 years. So after 25 years of lease, then the property will be reverted back to the owner. So the reversion will only start after 25 years. Okay? Okay, so now we are going to do the valuation. Okay, so we are going to start with term number 1. As you can see, indicated by the yellow color. Okay, the first box. The first box for term 1. Okay, right. So before we proceed with the valuation for term 1, okay, we must make sure that you have put the interest, okay, the yield involved. Okay, so for revert, we must start with reversion first, because we know during reversion we are going to use the all risk yield. Okay, this all risk yield will reflect all the growth, all the risk involved during the reversion. So in this case, the ARY is 7 percent. Okay, so we learn during the term, the yield that we are going to use will be lower than the ARY because, okay, the tenant are paying a lower rental. Okay, we learn that higher yield means higher risk. Okay, lower yield means lower risk. So why is during the term the risk is low? Because the tenants are happy to pay the rental because the rental is lower than the rental value. Other people are paying more. Other people are paying higher. Okay, so that is why the yield during the term would be lower than the ARY. Okay, so for term 2, the yield is we have to minus 0.5 than the ARY. That is why the yield that we are going to use in term 2 is 6.5. Okay, and for term 1, the yield that we are going to use will be less than term 2. Okay, so 6.5, we minus another 0.5, the yield that we are going to use will be 6%. Okay? Okay, ready for valuation? Okay, we are going to do the valuation for term 1. Term 1, the rent received is 50,000 ringgit per annum. Net, okay, and then you would multiply it with YP for 10 years. Why 10 years? Because the first term started from 0 to 10 years. Okay, so that is why YP for 10 years at 6%. Now, why 6%? We must use a yield that is lower than the reversion or the ARY. Okay, so in this case, for term 1, we are going to use 6%. Okay, so now you don't have to use the formula like what you did in part 1. So, what we're going to do now, you are going to use the Paris valuation table. And then you are going to look at YP single rate. Okay, so we do not write YP single rate in the valuation. Instead, we write it as YP for 10 years at 6%. Okay, once you have found the answer in your Paris valuation table, you must make sure you take only 4 decimal place. 4 titik perpuluhan sahaja. Okay, right, so you will get the answer for YP for 10 years at 6% is 7.3601. Okay, then you would multiply YP with the rent. So the rent received 50,000 multiply by 7.3601, the YP, and we will get the answer of 360,005 ringgit. Okay, so 368,005 for term 1. Okay, we are going to continue with the valuation for term 2. Term 2, as indicated in the slide, that will be colored by the yellow color. Okay, remember, term 2, there is a PV or present value involved because for term 2, the box, okay, as you can see, the box for term 2 will only start after 10 years. Okay, so that basically means for term 2, there will be a present value involved after 10 years. Okay, and then for how many years the YP? As you can see from the diagram, okay, 25 minus by 10, the YP is will be for 15 years. So we are going to do the valuation for term 2. As indicated before, the yield for term 2 would be slightly lower than the ARY, but higher than the yield that you are going to use in term 1. The term 1, the yield that we use is 6%. Okay, therefore, for term 2, the yield would be 6.5. Okay, slightly higher because during term 1, it is lower risk, the lowest risk because the tenant is paying a lower rent. Okay, so now we are going to proceed with term 2 valuation. Okay, since we have do the valuation for term 1, we are going to proceed with the valuation for term 2. Okay, so term 2, the rental received is 55,000 ringgit per annum net. Okay, and then we will multiply it with YP for 15 years at 6.5. Okay, now why 15 years? Because as you can see from the diagram before, 25 minus 10. Okay, the lease for the period, second period for term 2 is 15 years. Okay, and then at 6.5. Why 6.5? Because the yield is higher than term 1 because the tenant is paying slightly higher. Previously, for term 1, the tenant only pay 50,000. But now, for term 2, the tenant has to pay slightly higher, 55,000. That is why the yield for term 2 is 6.5. Okay, again, we are going to use the Paris Valuation Table book. Okay, and then to get this YP single rate. Okay, once you get the answer from the Paris Valuation Table book, okay, you will get the answer is 9.4027. Okay, but please bear in mind the for term 2, there would be a present value involved. Remember the diagram before? The box for term 2 will only start after 10 years. Okay, that is why the present value is for 10 years at 6.5. You just have to follow the yield. Okay, for PV, you have to follow the yield as the YP. If the YP is 6.5, then the PV, the yield would be also 6.5. Okay, so you are going to again look into Paris Valuation Table to get the answer for present value. Okay, once you look at the book, the Paris Valuation Table book, okay, you will get the answer point. Remember, present value always started with point. So, if it start with point, then you have to make sure you put zero in front of it. So, 0.5327. Again, you will only have to take 4 decimal place. Okay, once you get the answer for present value, then you have to multiply it all together. That basically means 55,000 per annum net multiply by YP for 15 years. So you will get 9.4027 multiply by present value, that would be 0.5327. Okay, once you multiply all that, you will get the answer. The answer is 275,485. This would be the answer for term 2. Okay, we are going to continue the valuation afterwards. Okay, so now we are going to do the valuation for reversion. Okay, for freeholder, there would be a reversion because once the lease is over, once the period of tenancy has expired, the property will be reverted back to the owner, to the freeholder, because as you can, as you remember, the freeholder basically means that the owner owns the property for perpetuity. Okay, so for reversion, again, we are going to use the rental value and also the all risk yield. Okay, there also be a present value involved. Okay, remember this arrow, the present value, the box or for reversion will only start after 25 years. Why 25 years? Because the lease, okay, the tenant only let or lease for 25 years. So remember, for reversion, there would be also a present value involved. Okay, when are we going to use this? In the valuations on the next slides. Okay. Okay, so let's continue with the valuation for reversion. Okay, during reversion, the valuation that we are going to use would be the rental value. In this case, the rental value would be 60,000 ringgit per annum net. Okay, then during reversion, the YP that we are going to use is not YP single rate. Instead, we are going to use YP reversion to perpetuity. Okay, but we do not write the YP reversion to perpetuity in our valuation. Instead, we are going to write YP in perpetuity at ARY deferred number of years. So in this case, the YP in perpetuity at 7%, because it is given in the question, the ARY is 7%. Deferred 25 years. Why 25 years? Because reversion will only start after the lease has expired. In this case, the lease period is over after 25 years. Okay, so then we are going to look at the Paris valuation table. Once you look at the book, you will get the answer. The answer for YP reversion, okay, you look at 7% and then the number of years is 25. The answer would be 2.6321. Okay, and then you must multiply it with the rental value. So the rental value, 60,000 ringgit per annum net, multiply by 2.6321, you will get the answer. So in this case, the answer is 157,926 ringgit. So that is the capital value for reversion. Okay, now we are going to continue with the valuation. Okay, once you have done all that for term 1, term 2 and also reversion, we are going to total up the whole value. Okay, let's recap back. You get the answer for term 1, the capital value is 368,005. For term 2, the value is 275,485. And for reversion, you get the answer 157,926. Okay, so in order to derive or to get the capital value for freehold interest, the value must be totaled up. So in this case, once you total up term 1, term 2 and reversion, you will get the answer. So the answer is 801,416 ringgit. Okay, 801,416. Okay, and you do not leave the answer just like that. Okay, remember we are going to round it up to the nearest thousand. In this case, since the nearest thousand is, you have to look at the thousands. Okay, so after that would be 4. 4 is the word and 500. So that basically means you do not have to round it up. Okay, so you are going to leave it to 801,000. So the capital value for the freehold interest for this valuation is 801,000 ringgit Malaysia. So that will be the answer for this question. Okay, to make sure that you understand our lesson for today, I need you to answer this tutorial question. Okay, the question would be, select the property for a term of 12 years. However, the rental would be different. The first 6 years, the rental is 3,000 per month net. And the next 6 years, the rental is slightly higher. That would be 3,200 per month net. Okay, so the market rental comparable is 3,500 per month net. And the ARY is given, that would be 6% per annum. So, estimate or calculate the capital value of this freehold interest. Okay, so don't forget to submit your answer for this tutorial. Okay, good luck!